JSchreck, BrianTrainer.com. Today what I'm going to do is I'm going to continue with this theme that I've had on back traction for the spine. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to talk about a stretch that I use, which is also a traction technique that I use using a band. Okay, this is a jump stretch band. It's like a 40, 41, 42 inch bit loop. They're great bands. To use, so if you're not familiar with these training tools, get familiar with them because they really work well. And you pretty much can see them in just about any gym anymore. They're pretty much all over the place. But anyways, what you're going to do is take your band and find a stable piece of equipment you're not going to be able to pull over, it's not going to move, and it has no sharp edges. So what you're going to do, take that band then, and then loop it around the band, and then loop it right through the hole in through itself. Okay, take the slack out of the band a little bit, and now your band is anchored. Okay, that's a great way to anchor the band if you've never known how to anchor bands. It's real simple. Now you can do it. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take my hands, I'm just going to put them inside the loop of the band, so the band's on the back side of my wrist. This is kind of important because I don't want to, with what I'm about ready to show you, I don't want to actually have to hold on to the band with my hands like this. Okay, I don't want tension in my hands. I want to try to stay loose. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put it on the back side of my hands and then kind of grab like this with my fingers. But when I'm actually sitting back, I'm just going to kind of like hold on to it, but I'm not really going to squeeze my grip real tight. From there, all I'm going to do, the band will come off my hands. Now I'm just going to step back away from the equipment, and I'm just going to start leaning forward, getting into a good morning type of position, a back flat. I'm kind of looking at you to talk, but I want to actually put my head in line with my arms. Okay, like that, when I'm doing this. All I'm going to do is just, feels so good. Step back, feel a good stretch. Hopefully I'm still in camera frame here. Get a good stretch here. I'm going to shift my weight back and forth, side to side a little bit. Feel everything kind of traction out and loosen up again. I would have my head in line with my arms. Okay, so from there, what I'm going to do is I'm going to squat down. I'm going to bring my hips underneath me and squat down into this position here. And then I'm just going to kind of lean forward. And again, I'm just going to let everything kind of traction out. Oh, it feels so good too. It's stretching out my lats, stretching out my low back, stretching out on my whole erector spine. Everything in my back is being stretched out right now. And now we're down here. I'm going to shift my weight from one foot to the other a little bit. Go ahead and twist just a little. You'll feel this stretch of everything out. I come up, stand up out of the stretch, back down in. Just do some squatting motions. Okay, twist it back and forth, and guys, that was great. It's a really great stretch. You get good traction to the spine there. You're alleviating all that tension. When I have my athletes do this, there's not a time limit here. You can do it as long as you want. You can do multiple sets. I tell them just to stretch out, feel everything. Make sure you're nice and loose, and guys, it really feels good. It's a great exercise to do as a deload after a heavy squat or a heavy deadlift day, or just even the next day after, in between sets even, just to kind of deload, decompress the spine and the disc, and just kind of loosen everything up. So hopefully that helps. If you've never done this, give this a shot. You will be addicted to this stretch, I guarantee it. I do it every day. It's wonderful. So guys, hope that helps. It's Jerry Schreck from BrianTrainer.com.